You see your city is broken. You see, that half of it is destroyed. If you don't come to aid and you don't come to your people, like, no one else is. And I think that we noticed that early on was that who was down on the street the next morning? It was the people.
كل شخص بعتقد مثلي كل شخص شاف هيدا الانفجار وشاف هيدا الشيء اللي صار اكيد بده ينزل ان كان من الجبل ولا ان كان من وين ما كان.
So we went to the Carantina hospital, the governmental hospital. And I met with the general manager and with the board of physicians, and I realized that we couldn't wait for donations to come from abroad. Just really needed to start now because the need was huge. And whatever equipment they had left was being stolen.
Yeah, this is something that that is very significant for me. It says, keep Lebanon close to your heart. And actually, this was created by a friend, Hala Tayyah, whom we lost in the blast. She created this initiative for people to always remember to love their country and to contribute. And since the blast, I never take this necklace out of my chest. You're gonna make me cry. So where do I continue from here?
None of the official structures have any clue what to do, or they didn't do anything, like literally anything. So people's solidarity brought people together, going door to door, house to house, cleaning houses, collecting donations, distributing food, trying to make the pain less and less on people, trying to stand in solidarity with each other.
We became the go-to NGO for healthcare. And so we started helping people. We started, you know, funneling them through our system, having them see our doctors for proper evaluation. And then, you know, giving them their medications.
هم الشباب كانت بأول يوم من أيام الانفجار كانت عم تنزل بكل دقيقة بكل المكانس والمعدات اللي موجودة ببيوتنا لحتى نكون عم نشيل الردم والإزاز. كنا عم ننزل وعم نخاطر حتى بحياتنا لما كنا عم نقرب على مباني هي أساساً كانت معرضة للانهيار.
So we had this initiative to create something called frontline engineers, as architects, engineers, designers, urban planners. So we started assessment of these damaged buildings one by one, and later on we will be managing like wash, electrical, plumbing, furniture, fit out things. But for the time being, we want them to be inside their home before rain season.
The thing that is really breaking my heart, that when I get into the migrant community homes and I see in what situation they live, some of them, they don't have even furniture in their home. I don't know how they're making it to sleep every night. They don't have food. So now, like my team in the beginning, we were focusing on all families, all homes, but now we're going to the poorest and the one that they're most in need, which is the migrant communities, and the migrant communities, they're the poorest.
When we saw the migrant workers, I had posted about that on my Instagram because I had a lot of friends in the US who wanted to help. And just that's how really like the PayPal donation started, and it really grew. I mean, everyone at the time just wanted to help in some way.
We set up a fund in the aftermath of the explosion to help rebuilding houses. Concern were extremely helpful in enabling us to make this project more impactful. They gave us training on how to approach people in their houses who are suffering from trauma, And additionally, they introduced us to the amazing women at Rise who were offering furniture for people's houses.
So we thought of, you know, reaching out to a network of people that we know, asking them to donate furniture which is in a very good condition that was not of use to them but could be of use to the people who lost their homes. And this is how the initiative started.
We distribute these tables, which we actually distribute in Greece, which are mobile workspaces, filled up with all kinds of tools. We even let the people decide what tools they need to migrant workers here. They can then unfold these tables and just join community volunteer projects or just use the tools and try to get an employment with contractors. I'm totally happy to do all with all of their decisions, like as long as they take ownership over this.
وسكرنا وما عاد في شيء مشان الكورونا من الكورونا ما في شغل كنت قاعد بالبيت ما في شيء بعدين بعد صار الانفجار كنا بنشتغل اكسترات اكس هيك مشي على البيوت بنلم ازاز وهيك شيء بعدين اتعرفت على شاب اسمه امين فهو عرفنا على شركه منظمه كونسير فاشتغلنا معاهم نحن شي 8 شباب من السودان اشتغلنا معاهم بجميز عم بنوزع خشب وشوادر على البيوت المتضررة
فطلبت أنا خيمة من كونسير من استاذهم جاب لي الخيمة والخيمة هلا عم تشتغل عم نطلع فيها قد ما نقدر تقريبا وصلنا ل 240 بيت صلحناهم من خشب من هيك قصص فيك تسأل هلا هيدا الحي كله اللي صار هو عائلتي أعطيت قد ما فيي لإله لأنه تضرر كثير وأغلبه هون سكانه ختايرة فبقعد أشرب فنجان قهوة معهم الصبح فهيدي بتسوى الدنيا كلها
It was a good and a rough week, and we all figuring out what we can do together, all together what we can do. I mean, if we hold our hands, we can do a lot bigger than we expect, you know? Because what Concern is doing right now is just connecting us together, all together in the same project, and just connecting. And actually, we are introducing ourselves to others, and others are accepting us.
كنا حسينا انه اللي اكثر شيء مستضعفين بالمجتمع هن المايجرنتس اللي عم يجوا وما حدا عم ينتبه لهم ايفن بعد البلاست وعم نجرب قد ما فينا نغير نظره المجتمع بالنسبه لهول الناس اللي نحن عم نعتبرهم اكثر شيء فيرنبل ونخليهم يصيروا يفوتوا بالمجتمع يعني كمان قررنا نفوت ناس من المايجرنتس نخليهم يكونوا عم بيساعدونا بقصص الترميم بلس عم بيساعدونا كمان بالقصص السوشيال اللي هن عم بيكونوا عم يفوتوا مع الكوميونتي مع الجروبات اللي هي على الارض الاكتيفست تنكون عم نعمل مثل انفولفمنت لهم بالمجتمع نحن بكونسيرن هيومانيتيريان نشتغل دائما بقصص انسانيه بعد ما شفنا شو الكيس اللي هي ببيروت وشو الحاجات اللي هي بحاجه لها تقسم البروجي لاثنين ريهابيليتيشن وكمان سوليداريتي بروجكت اللي هي بتستهدف الكوميونتي اللي بلشوا قبل كل الان جي او يشتغلوا على ارض الواقع وكانوا اسرع من كل الان جي او كان صار مثل اكستشينج للمعارف والقدرات اللي نحن عنا اياهم ولكمان اللي هن عندهم اياهم ومثل نعبي الجاب بين ان جي او وبين الكوميونتي اللي هي عم تنزل على الارض
But it just never stops in Lebanon because Well, we had the economical crisis, then we had COVID, then we had the blast, and now there is an even bigger problem, which is the fact that soon enough, the government's going to lift the subsidization for medications. And this is really where we really need to intervene very quickly and find solutions, because otherwise most people, even people who still have jobs today, won't be able to afford their medications.
من قلبي سلام لبيروت وقبل للبحر والبيوت لصخرة كأنها وجه بحار قديم